Hey, what's up guys? Mario here. I wanted to make a short video to explain a couple things. I always get asked to see if I do custom work, and the answer is yes, I do custom work. But in order for me to try to make whatever you're asking, I always ask to give me some dimensions or a design. It doesn't have to be nothing fancy. You don't need to have a special programs to draw or anything. All I need is just something simple, like let's say this picture right here, which is just a piece of paper with a pencil drawing telling me, let's say, the height, the width of the size of the reservoir that you want. But let's say on this case something's on the way and you need a cutout. All I need is the same thing, just the measurements from one corner to the other corner to try to explain to me, you know, how big is the cutout from, you know, from where to where you need it to be cut out. To make it, let's say, a little more difficult will be you need some G and a quarter in a specific spot. You can do the same thing, just send me the measurement from the edge to the center of the G and a quarter, or you can, let's say, you cannot get the center, you can only get me the edge of the G and a quarter, so you can just point it out to me, telling me that from one side to the border of the circle, it's let's call it on this case 0.75 inches instead of 1 inch going all the way to the middle. But that just to make it a little, let's say, more difficult, or someone that wants something more specific in order to create maybe a distribution panel for water to go from this side to the other side, or, you know, there's, you know, a lot of things that you can do. But all I need is just, you know, measurements telling me where you want, you know, certain things to be a little more custom to your case, let's say. Like on this case right here, this panel, it's a little more difficult since I have to duplicate it. But it has a little more cutouts and it has a lot of G and a quarters. But let's say you didn't wanted to send this piece to me. What I did was trace the cutout, try to get all the exact measurements on each little piece. So when I input all these measurements into the program I use, I can actually duplicate this piece without having any problems. The same thing with the G and a quarters. I just measure it from the edge to the center. And let's say maybe from this edge to the center of each, or don't matter from which edge, but at least I need to have some type of a reference to know where is this G and a quarters located. If you just send me, let's just say you send me a picture from above with just some little circles and no numbers or anything, I mean, I can figure it out how far is this G and a quarter away from this edge just by looking into pictures. So I just wanted to make this video to explain some of the things. I feel like some people sometimes get afraid when I ask to send me measurements or drawings or pictures. I feel like they're expecting me to receive CAD programs or, you know, something really, maybe something only professionals can actually make, let's call it. But it doesn't have to be nothing like that. It can be, like I said, just something simple with measurements telling me where each G and a quarter you is located, if you want it, you know, in a specific location, or you know, the just the width and the height. And you can say the rest of the design, you leave it up to me, kind of. Maybe if you just wanted a reservoir, you can just tell me plain, you know, open reservoir, just one chamber. Or you say I want it double chamber but split down in the middle this way or the other way. You can just start to get a little more specific once we get, you know, the basics. But that's what I'm gonna be doing right now. Just gonna input all these measurements with all the centers of the G and a quarter to duplicate this piece. Now that I have input all the measurements into Vectric Aspire, I'm gonna be doing something a little different. Since this piece have to be an exact match, I'm gonna cut an stencil with the CNC just to make sure all the G and a quarters and all the cutouts are on the same spot. Here I have the stencil I just cut with the CNC. It has all the G and a quarters, all the little holes that are needed to secure this piece back into the case, plus all the cutouts. And by the look of it, it's an exact match. Maybe right here at the top it has a little lip, little extra lip, but I mean that's gonna be perfect. It has all the G and a quarters on the spot that the customer wanted it, so this piece is ready to be cut with the CNC. Now that I have checked that everything matches, let's see. Yes, even the tiny little holes that are needed to secure this piece back into the original case are on the same spot as the stencil. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. You can follow me on Twitter and Instagram or Facebook. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.